Dear students, today we are going to discuss another topic in computer-based accounting. This is going to be the chapter 2 of your study program. Now, before we start our discussion for the day, first of all, we need to open up the Peachtree Premium Accounting software package. If you have an icon available in your desktop, you can double-click and you can open up your program. So once it opens, generally program will now open up with the sample company which you have created. As you can see from my screen, it is open up the Calum company. So that is the company we have created during the session number 1 or the chapter number 1 in the last week discussion. So if it is there, now to do the studious lecture, what we need to do, you can go to the file command. And then you can go to the new company creation command, because today we are going to create our common company which will be using for the whole sessions, a whole period, and updating daily basis by using the various lectures. So first of all, you go to the file and then go to the new company command. Then you can click OK for close this company. Then that will be closing and this particular window will get open if you cancel this. Or some people are here at the moment, you can keep as it is. Now first of all, let me explain this particular window. Last time also I skipped that. Now you can see there are two buttons available in this particular window. Button number 1, to open up an existing company. Now if you have created many company in your hard disk, in your computer, then you can open up one of these companies by clicking open an existing company. Already create කරලා තියෙන company hard disk එකෙන් open කරන්න ඕන නම් අපිට පුළුවන් click කරන්න open an existing company. When you open up, you can see all the companies which you have created under the particular program will appear according to the date schedule and the place. It will be saving all the time in the C program files within that C program file. So all the C drive companies what you have created will appear here. From that also we can select the appropriate company and click OK and open up our company if it is necessary, right. Second button, you have already known to it, create a new company. May button use karala apita puluwan aluthen thawa company create karanna. Other than that, there are two tasks which we can do using this particular window. Explore the sample company. So there are some sample companies. If you have a time, please go to one of these sample companies, click OK, open up and see how the transactions are carried out by the particular business organization using this particular package, right? Those are very old companies, but still for your study purpose, that is good. You can navigate when you have a free time. And also you can remember, we can convert some other software programs into the Sage 50 or the Peachtree accounting software program. So when you click that, you can see what are the supportive softwares which we can convert it to the Peachtree or to the Sage 50. You can see it's a QuickBook and DAC Easy packages are easily convertible to the Sage 50 or to the Peachtree package, right? So that is one of the option whereby you can convert from one package to another package, right? So the today's lecture material will be chapter number 2, create in a new company. As you can see, there are a lot of outcomes we expected from you by creating this company. So please remember one important thing: when you are converting your business organization activities from the manual system into the computerized environment, it is vital and important to create your own company first of all in the system. Without having the company which you have created within the system, you are not able to run your day-to-day operations of the business. So that's why creating a company is the starting point of after installing your software. That is the starting point of handling the software package in the business organization. So any business organization having softwares at the initial stage, what they do, they will first of all create their own company, right? So the creating company will guide through a lot of activities. Now we will go by that one by one and we will try to understand everything in this handout and we will create our companies. That is for the BCom as well as the accounting graduates, right? So the Sage 50 or the Peachtree package walk you through the process of creating a new company. So it's a guiding window which will help you to go through and create your company. You can remember last week we discussed and we created a sample company giving our own name. Now today we are going to create a common company. Each of you going to have the same data, and we also are going to have the same data whereby we can check our answers without any problem. This makes it easier to get your new company started. So this will create a new environment whereby it is very easily you can handle your business organization activities. You need only to enter the minimum information to the initial step of your company. So if you need to quickly create your company, you can enter the minimum information initial stage and then you can add more information into the system, right? So that is also possible because all the things for this particular window, some of the windows which we are going to enter, can be edited after creating the company. This information include the chart of account, accounting method, posting method, accounting period, structure and so forth. Very important areas, you need to think about your chart. That means how you are going to get the ledger accounts to your company, how many accounts you require and how you are going to develop them. That is called chart of account. And accounting methods, so what are the accounting methods you are going to use to run the company, whether it's a cash base or whether it's going to be accrual base. Posting method, whether it's real-time posting or the later posting, we want batch processing, we need to decide. And also accounting period structure, whether this is 12 months or more or less than 12 months, that you have to decide, right? After you complete the creating a new company, Sage 50 offers a setup guide. So setup guide is a helping guide. You can see where every time when you open up your program, that setup guide will appear. But we don't have to go through the setup guide. If you like to read that, especially you can do it. But we will be learning everything with us together, with our lecturers. So there will be no issues. Every issue can be discussed and sorted out. So this is the introduction for the starting point to create your new company. Now we will look at what are the options available to create your new company. Let's move into the activity number 2.2, creating a company using the create a new company wizard. There are many steps, as I told you earlier, there are many steps which you can use to create your company. So you can go to the Sage 50 startup window and then you can go to the create a company command and then you can click the next button. And also from the file menu, you can select the new company and you can do that creation part. So let me show the both activity using the Sage 50 window. Now if you look at this diagram here, the screenshot given in your screen, now the one option is you can go to the file and then you can click the new company command, which will help you to create a new company. And also if you are in a starting window, whereby you can click the create a company button, whereby you will be able to create your new company. So these two options are available in your package. If you go to the package, one option is called file and then go to the new company, whereby you will get to the guiding window. Using this particular window, we can create our new company. That is one method. Second method, if you are in a starting window, then you go to the create a company button and that will open up the same window. So my dear students, simply there are two ways which you can start your program by creating your own company information, clicking the file or selecting new company, and secondly you can either click start button and then go to the new company creation, right? These are the two options. So I hope you got the idea how to create the company by using any method. Now we can create our company. Okay, so once you followed one of these above two method, the create a new company information window will appear. Tharaputala e option dekene ekak select karot ogalanta enawa create a new company open window eka. So guiding window eka me thiyenne guiding window eka. Thara Sage 50 tharaputala pawichchi karat a Peachtree package එක පාවිච්චි කරත් similar kind of window will get open to your screen. So it will ask you to do the certain activity. It is noted that you can change the company information at any time. පුතාලා company information ඕනම වෙලාවක වෙනස් කිරීමේ හැකියාවක් පෙන්වනවා දෙනවා, right? ඊට පස්සේ අපිට තියෙන්නේ මෙන්න මේ පළවෙනි window එක company information window. This particular window help us to enter the profile of our company. Location, name, then the telephone numbers, fax numbers, method, type of business, website, email and so forth related to the very vital and important information which need to be printed into the various document which you are printing through the system, right? So to enter this we have already done, so we don't have to waste our time much because you have already created the first company. Now you know how to create it, and also remember one required information field is there without which you cannot move, so that is called company name. තරක්තලට company name එකක් නොදා මේක ඊළඟ step එකට යෑමේ හැකියාවක් නැහැ. නමුත් company name එක විතරක් දාලා අනිත් දේවල් පුරවන්න නැතුව අපිට ඉස්සරහට ගිහිල්ලා පස්සේ මේවා නැවත වරක් පිරවීමේ හැකියාව තියෙනවා. So that's what editing option is available, and you can see at the bottom it says you can edit this information after your company created. Now it's vital for you to create your first company, common company, that is called activity number 2.2. Now our accountancy graduates or the accountancy second year students will create a company called AFMA 2020 Private Limited, and simultaneously our friends from the BCom department can create a company called BCom. So we'll keep the capital letter, BCom 2020 Private Limited, PVT LTD company. So these are the two companies which the two undergraduates going to create. So the accountancy graduates are going to create the AFMA 2020 Private Limited, and meantime BCom students are going to create BCom 2020 Private Limited. So what I will show now, I will be creating using the same information. When you have the handout, there's an option whereby you can copy this information and paste that into the appropriate windows. පුතාලට ඕන නම් මේ දීලා තියෙන handout එක copy කරලා ඒකේ තියෙන information paste කිරීමේ හැකියාවක් තියෙනවා. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඕගලන්ට කැමති නම් type කරන්න. Then you have to get the printout of this handout. Then you can process that into your computer or the Peachtree package or to the Sage 50 package. So let me start. So I will be using the copying command because it's easy for me. We can copy the name of the company. Now we are creating a company called AFMA 2020 Private Limited. This is only for the accounting graduate. So either you can use the create a company option or you can go to the file and new company option. So this is your initial window. Then nothing to do here. We will go to the next step. And here the company name where we can paste the name which we have created, right? So this is AFMA 2020 Private Limited. Now students from the BCom department need to create a company called BCom 2020 Private Limited, right? So each of you do accordingly. Now for the BCom students, please remember that you need to take your company name, that is going to be the BCom Private Limited, and that is the name you have to use here to enter your company name, right? Make sure you will be entering the BCom 2020 Private Limited. Other than that, all other informations are common to both of you, so easily you can put, right? So the company name is the only difference here in your case, so we can adjust it. Even here we can say AFMA 2020 Private Limited, that is our accountancy graduates accounts or the company which they are going to create. Then you have two lines, line number one, line number two, and you got a city, you got a country, whereby you can break your address nicely and put that into the different location. Now here I have given address line one, it is going to take the University of Sri Jayawardenapura, so we will take that and enter as a address line one, University of Sri Jayawardenapura. Then we will go to the second line and we will enter the Gangodavila as a second line. Gangodavila is going to be the second line address of our company. Thirdly, we can enter the city. City is going to be Nugegoda. Then we can go for the Nugegoda and enter that as a city. So we will go back and enter. When you paste it, city will appear. And also the country is given. So we can either type, either copy it and paste. Country, we can enter the Sri Lanka as a country in this particular company. So now we have entered the name of the company and the initial working address of the company, maybe the head office, maybe the head office main branch of the company, it's entered here. Then we got a chance of entering the telephone numbers and fax numbers. So if you have only one telephone number, you enter that. If you have many telephone numbers with the backstroke, you can enter all the telephone numbers, right? So you can enter the telephone number and we can enter our fax number, which was given to you. It need to be the common information for both of you. And then we can go to the rest of the details. Limited liability company. So the business type, no need to copy and paste. You know the business types can be selected from the drop down list. From that we will select commonly used in company type called limited liability company. And we are not going to use the federal employee IDs, state employee IDs and the state employer IDs. So we can skip those things. Next we have to enter our website. Now again we can enter the full website details as far here, and the BCom students can do a small modification to that. You enter the website first, then place of ACC, BCom students can type com. So they can type com, right? So that can be the BCom student, and the accounting students can type ACC. So your website www.mgt.sjp.ac.lk/ACC for the accounting students, and if you type the same thing to your BCom students, need to type www.mgtsjpac.lk.com, and so that will be your website. Then the email address, similarly we can adjust it. Now here we can see the ACC address is there. Now for the BCom student, they can adjust that to their own address, right? So accounting students can type acc@sjp.ac.lk, and com students can type here place of acc com@sjp.ac.lk. So please do it accordingly, right? So that will be the company. Now we have fulfilled almost all the required information relevant to this particular company. So you can see everything is there. So we can now go to the next step to do the next step. And also you can see you can edit this information after your company is created at any time. So there's opportunity of changing all this information and create a company again, right? So update your company by giving the different information. Later on, if the address change, telephone numbers change, immediately go to the edit command and do that edit. So we will later look how to make the editing as well. So this is the page number 1, whereby we completed the activity number 2.1 given to you. So it's a common company we are going to create for the both parties, BCom as well as the accounting students. Only the differences are company name and the mailing and your website addresses. Those things you can adapt according to your method. So let's move on to the next window. Method to create company. So we are moving into the next window by clicking the next button. When you click the next button, you will be now in the second window, which is called select a method to create your company. As we have already discussed, there are 5 options available here, whereby you can select one of the options and do your activities. Out of these 5 options, most important at the time of creation of your company is the option number 1 and the option number 4. So these 2 options will help you to create a new company either using the sample companies given by the software developers, or either create your own company but without taking anyone's chart of account. So that gives the opportunity for you to create exactly what is required for your own business organization, right? So before we move on to the activities, let us learn what are the features available in each of these sections by using the handout, because I am not going to run through each of these again. So let me go back to your handout, and if you look at here, the second window in the creating a company process is selecting the method to create a company. Once you click on the next button in the create new company, company information window figure number 2.3, which you can see similar to what you have seen earlier, will get appear. There are five activities which can you can carry out using this particular window, right? But mostly important is the activity number one and activity number four, whereby you can create your company by using either samples or your own chart of account. Now taking එකට බලමු using a sample business type. Select this option to copy the basic setup information, particular a chart of account from the sample company. තොර පුතාල මේ option එක අපි කරා last week එකේ ඔයගලන්ගේ sample company හදන වෙලාවේ. එතෙන්දී අපි කරේ anu විසින් develop කරන ලද chart of account එකක්, එහෙම නැත්නම් collection of account එකක් accept කරා. එතකොට අපි කවුරු හරි develop කරපු software එකක් මේ chart of account එකක් අරගෙන accounting system එකක් අරගෙන අපේ company එකට අපිට ඕන විදිහට modify කරන්න තමයි හදන්නේ. So that is called select a sample company. You can select either the simplified chart of account and continue only the basic account needs, or you can go to the very specific type and select the specific type of accounts you require, right? So if you are going by that, you need to select the option number one, and then you have to go to the next option. Here you can see the simplified type. There are major categories of businesses: construction, distribution, manufacturing, retail, and service. Each of these major categories will get a simplified chart of account or the collection of account, which we can accept and get that into our own company and then later on modify. Or we can go to the detail types and we can select very appropriate company which is equal to what we are going to do. So we can select various type of company from the list of 140 companies given in this particular list. So තලට ගැලපෙන කම්පැනියක් එතනින් තෝරගන්න පුළුවන්. හැබැයි මේ අපි ගන්නෙ අනුන්ගේ chart of account එක. අරගෙන we need to do the modification. You can see you can edit the account after your company created. તો මේ ගත්තා කියලා කිසිම ප්‍රශ්නයක් නෑ. Anytime you want you can edit that, right? So if you want to select like that, you can go by this option, right? So that is the option called create your company by using the sample. So there you can see the two different type which was mentioned earlier, simplified and detail type. So the more details are available in your handout. I hope when you have a free time you will be able to read and understand everything. Now the second option, if you select the second option, not the first option, right? If you I go back to the activity, so we will go back to our activity. When you select the second option, that means this copy setting from the existing Peachtree account in company. So what is happening there in select, when you select the copy setting from the existing Sage 50 account in company, in this option if you want to copy the settings in setup information from another existing Sage company. තොර පුතාලා දැන් එක Sage company එක හදනවා ARC company කියලා, තව එකක් හදනවා HFA කියලා, තව එකක් හදනවා BCom කියලා. එතකොට දැන් අපි අලුතෙන් හදන්න යනවා තවත් company එකක් ABC කියලා. අතන ABC company එකට මේ හදලා තියෙන early structures තුනෙන් එකක් ඕනේ නම් we can select the particular company structure and that we can copy to this particular new company as well. So you can see how it is done in the figure number 2.6. I am not going to go with the software package and do these things, so you can experiment those things when you have free time. So you can see many companies already created in the system are appearing here. If you your new company want to take one of these companies structure, then you can select that appropriate company and then you can click the next button to copy that information to your window. So that is the second option, which is called copy settings from the existing Sage 50 account in company, right? So that is what we need to select. Go to the next. Now you can see several companies are already created within the system. So if you want to copy something from here, highlight that and then copy that structure to your company as well. Okay, you got an idea. I think you got an idea how to do that. So we are not going to do it that activity. So you can back it and you can come to the main window. So that is the option we call second option, right? Then move on to the third option. Now here how to copy various type of things to be copied in this next window. If you go to the next window, you can see that. Let me show it again. So you go to the here and if you select the particular company, go to the next. So they are asking question whether you want to copy the chart of account, accounting period, statement of report. If you want all these things, you can tick. If you don't want the account in period to be copied, chart of account only you want, then you can remove the other ticks. So it will copy only the chart of account and even the dates you had fixed according to your new system, right? Likewise, you can adapt it. So let me go back. Then the third option is called converting the company from another account in software. Now when you go to that option, you can see converting option. We know we can convert the Peachtree into the Peachtree package, DAC-EASY and the Mayo programs, whereby you can click that and then you can go to the next and convert it. So it's a way simply converting the current available system into the new software package, right? So that can be done very easily. That is converting your company. Then the fourth option, building your own chart of account. Very, very important and essential for all of you. Build your own chart of account. So you can select that option. It is designed for the accountants and the advanced users only, whereby the system is not going to give a single account to you. Not a single account. There will be empty chart of account, whereby you allowed to create all the accounts by your own, according to your wish, according to your structures, according to your environment. So that will give you the opportunity to set up your own chart of account, which will expect it from both accounting as well as the BCom undergraduate, whereby you will be creating a chart which gives the zero number of samples, right? Whereby we will design our own system. So you can go by the segmentation. You know what you mean by the segment. Segment is the branch account. Now most of the companies are looking for the performance of the individual departments, maybe the individual branches, maybe the individual outlets, where you want to check whether each of these sections are generating the profit for you for the various decision making purpose. For that, there's an option called define account segment, whereby you can generate individual accounts for the lower levels, middle levels, upper levels and the higher levels. All levels can be generated through this system, right? So that is called defining account in segment. We will be doing that. Now we are coming to that activity immediately and we are going to create our company. And meantime, before we do that activity, let's look at the other option, converting, consolidating the existing Sage 50 account in software. That means if you select last option, consolidating the existing software, that is the option we are talking here. So let me explain that. If you are working in the Sage 50 accounting, you can consolidate the company. So if you have a group of company accounts available, then you can prepare the consolidated account very easily by using consolidated company is one of the combine of chart of accounts of the number of existing Sage 50 companies. So the chart of accounts need to be very much matched, because if you are having the same type of business organization, so you can consolidate that. You can bring them together and you can create the consolidated account. So that is called subsidiary companies can manage to get the final account prepared as a consolidated financial statement. So you can see the window which you are going to get. And from there, we can consolidate any accounts. You can add those accounts here and then you can ask the computer to go to next step and consolidate it. So that will get you the consolidation account. So I hope you got an idea of all the features available in the window number 2. And our option is going to be build your own chart of account for the AFMA as well as the BCom company, right? So we will be selecting build your own chart of account, which was designed for accountants and for advanced users of this particular accounting software package. Okay, now everyone can select the option number 4, build your own chart of account, which was designed for you specially. So select that option and then click the next button. When you click the next button, you can see the define accounting segment window will get open. So what do you mean by the segment? Segment is the branch account, or you want to generate the financial statement for the various levels. So up to maximum of 5 levels, we can generate the report. Say you got the main company at the top. So that is your company, number 1. Number 2, you got the, say, branches. Under the branches, you got divisions. Under the division, you got the outlet. Under the outlet, you may be having sales rep. So if you want to evaluate the individual sales rep performance, you should create the sales rep account under the category line number 5. If you want to select the level 4, then you can select the outlet wise performance. Then if you go to the 3, division wise performance. When you go to the 2, branch wise performance. Then you come to the final one, whereby you can get the overall company. So the modern situation, modern business world, every business organization willing to see the segmental accounting reports, whereby each segment need to generate some kind of profit to the business. Otherwise, you can take the decision whether you are going to continue or discontinue those segments if it is not profitable to the business organization. Now, there can be a situation where the business organization don't want to have a segmental account. In that case, we can say the first option, no, I don't want to use the accounting segment, accounting masking. So that means you don't want segmentation. In that case, you can generate only one financial statement, whereby you can see the overall picture of your business. But if you like to generate the level-wise income statement, then you have to tell, yes, I would like to go for the segmentation or the masking. Now, the maximum length whereby you can use the code. Now, it is very important you to understand the coding system. Generally, computerized environment always going with the codes, right? These codes are very vital because code, depending on how many codes you are going to give for the account, number of account is going to be decided. Now, for example, if you have only two coding system, you can create the maximum number of account is 99 account. You start with the 01 and go up to 99. So that is the maximum range whereby you can create the number of account. If you are going by three coding system, you can go up to 999 accounts. If you go by four coding system, you can go up to 9999 account. That is more than enough for any large business organization. And the five coding system allows you to go by 99,999 accounts. So if you are going by the single account in coding system, your recommended coding level is 4 to 5 codes, right? Whereby you can generate and you can incorporate many accounts. Why you need this kind of range? Because sometimes the companies in future also going to add more and more accounts. They are going for the new businesses. So in that case, you need to have a space whereby you can add the account. So if you are going by one single coding system, the maximum number of account you can create is 9. If you go to the 10th account, the coding system need to be readjusted by adding 0 to the all accounts. So that will be the problem for the business organization. That's why it is vital for you to select how many length you are going to take for each and every account. So the maximum length, including the separators and everything, need to be 15 characters. It can be numbers, it can be letters, it can be combination of letters and numbers, right? So that need to be there. So you can see when it comes to the segmentation, right? Now, what we are going to do for our AFMA and also the BCom company, we are going for the two levels. GL level, we will say company level, that we will change now. Company level. So the company level, we are going to select our company. So the company need to have a generally four coding system. And the division, we are going to give two more codes. So according to this situation, whereby we can get the divisional report as well as the company amalgamated report, right? So that's what we want to do. So that is the idea of giving 4 to 2 coding system. So that is the length. So the maximum length is taken here, 4 code for the company, and then the separator, that is 5, and 2 more code for the division, that is 7. So 7 coding systems are going to be used for the AFMA and BCom company. So how to create that? So first you say yes, then you got the segmentation name. First one is company, and give the length how much you want the codes, 4 codes, and then you can select one of the separator. Once you select the one particular separator, make sure you need to continue with the same separator. You cannot change that. Otherwise, the computer will tell you given message that is not matching with the given structure, right? Then you go to the second level, division level. So we got division. So for the division, we want to have 2 codes only. And then after that, we are further not going to go. Branch and so forth, we are not going to go. That's why we have to stop this and say none. So we are closing it. Now you can see your structure, accounting structure. There will be 4 codes, either letters, either combination of letters and numbers. Then you have to have a small dash, and then you have to have 2 more codes to get the overall structure of your account. So this is the coding structure of your account, And similar manner, you can see the length of your account number is going to be 7 characters, right? Once you finish that, then you have to click the next button to go to the next level. So here we are moving into the next level. So we have created activity number 2.4 for the both companies, whether it is going to be BCom 2020 Private Limited or it is AFMA 2020 Private Limited. Both companies, you should have the same characters and you should get the company and the division as the second level, right? So the first level is called company, second level is called division. Then once you complete that, you are coming to the next activity, that is next window, which is called choosing an accounting method. Now here you can see, and also you can remember last time also I explained to you detail wise this. This cannot be changed after your company created. So the even though manual system is not allowing you to manipulate the data by changing the accounting method year by year. So first year you say I am going to go by cash basis, and next year you are telling I am going to prepare my accounts on accrual basis. That is not allowed. Right, it's a policy wise, it is not going to allow for any business organization. That's why it's very important us to select firmly whether our business organization actually working in the accrual environment or in the cash environment. Right, most of the companies are generally practicing the accrual based accounting, that is the accounting system available in the world. But there can be situation where you can see the cash based accounting are practicing, mostly the government organization. Maybe the clubs, maybe the societies, maybe the association like your own association, AFMA or the BCom student association. So you may be maintaining your account on cash basis. Now the students are in the second year students. It's good for you to prepare your accounts using one of these packages. Once you finish learning this package, you will be able to, now you are the people handling the AFMA or the BCom student union. So you will be able to prepare your accounts by using the package. Whereby it's a practically you are going to use your knowledge to do these activities in practical manner, right? So you can go by either accrual, either cash base. And remember, this cannot be changed after your company created. That's why you have to take a firm decision here whether you are going by accrual or the cash base. Now the details of the accrual concept and the cash base concept is given here. You all are knowing, I am not going to repeat this, you are not learning the accounting for the first time, right? So you all are learn accounting for many, many years. So you all know what do you mean the accrual based concept and what do you mean the cash based concept. Still, if it is difficult for you to understand, please read this handout carefully and try to understand what do you mean by accrual concept and cash based concept. Once you choose that accounting method and finish creating a new company, you can't change the method use of the company. After creating the company, you should not change that method again, right? It is not allowed by the system. System will block that. So that's why we are allowed you to select firm decision need to be taken from here and you select it. Now, according to AFMA and the BCom company, both companies, AFMA or the BCom, we are going to use the basic concept called accrual base. That is the modern accounting base, right? So we will be selecting accrual. And then we need to go to the next step. Next step is choosing the posting method. Now, assuming you all are good in doing these activities and we don't have much of the time of rechecking our data, so we all are going to select the real-time posting method. As you can see, the next item is the posting method. How frequently you want to update your ledgers. Right here, what they are selecting, how frequently you want to update the ledger. Whether you want to update your ledger immediately after creating the transaction or whether you want to update your ledger little bit later after creating the transaction. So in the batch processing, it will be going to the temporary file. Initial stage, okay, when you are creating the transaction, it will save in the temporary file. And the second stage, accountant or the higher authorized person need to check all the accounts accuracy of the transaction. Then he can post that by using one button and posting into the system. But assuming that you all are familiar with accounting, you will do the proper job, and we are using the same handout to discuss here. So it is better by everyone to select the real-time posting method. So select the method called real-time posting, right? Everyone need to select the same method because at the end of the day, we want to cross-check our data. So make sure everyone is selected real-time posting. And then you go to the next step. Once it comes to the next step, again, very crucial window will appear. Choose an accounting period structure. whether a particular company is practicing 12 months calendar year system or the monthly based system, whereby the 12 months, after 12 months you want to check your final account, or you want to check your final account early than 12 months or more than 12 months period. So generally, if it is not matching with the calendar 12 months, you should select the second option, which I have already discussed in the last lecture as well, whereby you can go from 1 month to 13 months calendar, right? So whereby you can, you have a project or you are working under the construction, you may be finishing your construction work by 7 months, then you have to set up 7 month calendar, whereby you can finalize your account after finishing the 7 month period. So that is the structure given here, right? So if you go to that, you can see here. So in our company, we are going to use the real-time posting. We have already selected activity number 2.4. It says you should select the real-time posting method. Then accounting period, when it comes to the accounting period, as I told you, again, there are two methods. Along with the accounting period, you need to set up Sage 50 fiscal year, even the Peachtree or the Sage 50, same windows. The first window will let you to choose the 12 option, 12-month calendar. So you go by 12-month period, and at the end of the 12-month period, you will be able to close your account and process to the new financial year. And if you are not going with that, you go for the different structure, whereby you can finish your financial year early than 12 months or after 12 months, maximum of 13-month period. So in our case, if you choose, you can look at the second situation in the window screen. If you choose, you have some accounting period arrangement, select accounting period that do not match with the option, then you will be going for the selection of the fiscal year periods, right? So this is the window we have gone to the last time as well, whereby you tell the computer how many months are incorporated in your financial year. According to that, system will readjust and they will get the calendar here, and then you have to tell the starting date of your financial year. And also remember, this cannot be changed after creating the company. So, පුතාලට මේ window එක හරිම crucial window එක මේක කරන ක්‍රියාකාරකම හරියටම තීරණය කරලා කරන්න ඕනි. එහෙම කරේ නැත්නම් අපිට මේක වෙනස් කිරීමේ අයිතියක් නැහැ. ආයි සරයක් මුලින් ඉඳලා අපිට එක් කරන්න වෙනවා. Right? Tell the Sage 50 how many accounting period you want. So, පුතාලා මෙතනින් කියන්න how many period you want. And then when you want to start your program, so then it will be created your financial year. Now let's look at what is the situation for you. Activity number 2.5, it says enter the financial year of the AFMA 2020 Private Limited as follows. Starting from the 1st of April 2020, going up to 31st March 2021. So we have to give the starting month only. So automatically system will create the financial year. That is the system. So we can select like that, and for the BCom 2020 Private Limited also we are going with the same financial period, so that's why no issue. Now we will go to the 12 month accounting period, because as we know, we are going by 12 month general practice. Most of the companies are choosing that financial year, because at the end of the 12 month we want to check our financial performance and financial strength of the business organization. So we'll go to the next step. And then we can tell the starting month, it says April, select the month, and the year you can go to the calendar and select 2020. So our company is going to start from the 1st of April 2020 and it will take 1 year as 31st March 2021, right? And also we can see the note saying we cannot change this activity after creating the company. It doesn't matter, now we have selected that appropriately, then we can go to the next step. And then finally, you are now in the final stage, whereby you can see how the company is created. Once the company is created, databases are created, you can see your screen. Once the company created at the top, here at the moment, we can see only the Peachtree accounting name is appearing in your title bar. You will get now the people who are doing for the AFMA 2020 company. They will see the AFMA 2020 company at the top. And if you create the company for the BCom 2020, then you will see the company name at the top called BCom 2020. So let's go to the finish button and click finish. And it will take few minutes to create the databases. You can see the system will create their own databases, whereby he will save all the information within these data files, database. So let's finish now. So we'll click yes. Then it will take your option whereby you can access into the system. So your company is opening, click yes. And now this is the setup guide. As I told you, every time when you open, it will give you the guide for helping you to go and do the activities. But you don't want Anytime you want, you can get that guide manual by clicking the file command. There you can see the setup guide, resources, online resources backup. It is not available here. Data verification, select important. No. So setup guide you cannot get from there, but somewhere else you can get that setup guide, right? So it is not necessary, it will automatically appearing, but you can get that at any time you want by clicking that, right? So it's there. So finally we can go. If you go to the banking module, you may be getting that item, or you go to the company information, setup guide is there, right? If you go to the setup company information, here setup guide button is available in the company information. If you want that setup guide, you click that button and get it, right? So anytime you want to read it, so you go to the company navigation button and click the setup guide, and that will appear, and you can do that activity without any problem, right? So this is how we can create our company. Now we got the finishing window, and finally we got finish and we got our company. So the 2.6, you have created the company called AppMart 2020 Private Limited, or you have created the company called VCOM 2020 Private Limited. So you can see the screenshot how it is created, and also you can see the Sage 50 line screenshots available in your handouts, whereby you can see there's a no difference between the Peachtree and the Sage 50 accounting package. So you can work both packages anytime, right? So that is the way we have to do it. Now, as you can see, we have already created, you have access into the company. And putala kalpanawen balanna accounting students lage tiyennone metana AppMart 2020 private limited kiyala e wageema anith ayage api BCom ayage tiyennone metana BCom 2020 private limited kiyala. So I hope you got the idea of how to create a company with the segmentation as well, right? So we have come to the conclusion of this particular lecture, but meantime we have to know how to edit this information as well. Let's look at viewing and editing the company information. That is your activity number 2.3 in this handout. Once you finish creating the company, you can see or edit information. Only allowable information. Some informations are editable, some information are not. You can remember, accounting method is not editable, as well as the financial period cannot be changed now, right? Other than that two things, anything else you can change. So to do that, how to change your company information, you can go to the maintain main menu, and then you can click the company information. So for example, if you go to the maintain main menu and then click the company information, from there we can go to the initially created company information, right? From that we can easily do that modification and do necessary required changes to your system. For example, now if you want, so let's look at a small modification. Here we are not given any activity, but let me show you how this can be done, right? So for example, now each of you have your registration numbers. So can you please enter your registration number here under the state employer ID? Just type your number, enter your registration number. Once you do that, because the new thing is changed now into the system, if you want to save that number, you should click the OK button. Once you click OK and go back and check that again, company information, you can see the registration number is already saved. So please enter your registration numbers there according to you. So you can see any information given here, the name of the company, address of the company, telephone numbers, fax numbers, email address, and the websites can change, and also the type of the business can change. Why it is allowed? Because now initially we can start a small business organization like proprietary organization, and once you are doing the business, you expand in your business, you got few friends, and now you think of going for the partnership, it allows to convert your business into the partnership. Further, when you are doing the partnership, you found that you are doing very well and you want to expand your business, you want to get the financial support from others, so you can convert that into the limited liability company. Likewise, we can go in this ladder to the highest level, converting that. That is allowed. That is allowed in the manual system as well. So that's why the system will allow you to do the changes. And also, posting method is allowed to change at any time. You can go, now we have selected the real time, but if I want to stop that and go to the batch processing, we can select and click OK. That will go by the batch processing, second level, right? So if you want to change, it is possible to change there. And you can see the accrual concept cannot be touched. It's blocked. and locked here. So no one can go to that and touch it now, right? So confirm your data here and click OK. Then the financial period, you can see, I will explain this as well. Here the period you have created, you are in the period number one. You go to the calendar, there are two calendars. System date calendar is the current date, and the period calendar is what you have created for the given company. So when you click the period calendar, you can see the drop down list. The beauty of this particular software package, it allows you to run for two financial period, two physical years without closing the account. එතකොට පුතාලට පුළුවන් ඕනනම් අවුරුදු දෙකක් ගිණුම් කරණය කරගෙන යන්න මේ පැකේජ් එක හරහා ගිණුම් ක්ලෝස් කරන්නේ නැතුව. Most of the software packages allows you to only to run the first year. First year close කරාම තමයි second year එක add කරන්නේ. හැබැයි මේ පැකේජ් එකේ පුතාලට first year එක ඉවරලා තව මාසයක් දෙකක් අරගෙන accounts close කරලා අලුත් year එකක් add කරගන්න පුළුවන්. So you can see two financial years are already added. First financial year starting from the 1st of April 2022, March 31st 21, and the second financial year starting from 1st of April 21 to March 31st 22. Tax years are also two different tax years, that's financial year and the tax year. And also currently we are in the period number one, right? We have not done anything. So automatically when you create the company, it will always waiting to get the information from you for the first period, right? So that is the period. Period is the month. Fiscal year is the financial year of your particular company activities, right? So you can see that is perfectly set, and you are not allowed to change this now. If you have done a mistake here, you need to start from the beginning and you have to create the again another company to do that. So these are the information whereby some information can be edited, some cannot be edited, and still we are in this position of going and doing all the activities, right? I hope you got an idea now how to create your company, and meantime setup guide informations are also provided in your handout. If you want to check that, now you can check that slowly, right? Now next item is, now we have completed creating the perfect company, which we are going to continuously use to discuss the topics, okay, and handouts, what is available in your LMS. So that then we have to keep the backup. Backup means keep the file copy of the today's activities in a separate place, whereby you can easily take that when it come to the next class, right? So let's learn how to backup the files. Last time also we did. There are various method again. First method, you can go to the file command main menu, then you can see the command called backup. By clicking that, you can select your company name need to be as a backup file. Tick on to the include the company name into the backup file name. Then click the backup button. Then you can see it will open up any place where you want to save. Select one of your drivers where the available drive, and then you select your, you need to create a folder for the particular subject. But make sure you create a folder. Now I have created the computer based account in second year killer folder. We can go inside that, then we can create another folder called backup folder, and we can open up last time what we have created is already there. And then we can create this company as well as a backup file and safeguard that in a separate place. AFMA 2020 Private Limited, and the date is appearing the day which I have created, that is today I have created, that is the July 17 2020, and click save, and then confirm it that much of space required, 3.18 megabyte, and then you click OK, and that will be saved in that particular place. Normally this will be saved in the hard disk as well. එතකොට පුතාලා use කරන්නේ laptop එක ගන්න මේ කම්පැනිය මෙතනම save වෙනවා. ඊළඟ පාර open වෙන්නේ මේ කම්පැනිය තමයි. නමුත් in case if something goes wrong, then you need to have a supportive backup. That is one way how you can backup the file. There's another way. If you go to the company navigation button, there also you can see the command called backup. By using this also we can do the same thing. එතන මෙතනිනුත් අපිට backup කරන්න පුළුවන්. දෙසරයක් backup ගන්න අවශ්‍ය නැහැ. එක බෑකප් එකේ අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ ඒක තියෙනවද කියලා බලන්න පුළුවන් නැවත පරීක්ෂා කරලා. You can go to your explorer, windows explorer, then you go to the particular folder, and if you have created the folder for the backup, you can see at the top today's date and the time which the backup file is taken. Everything is perfectly there, so we can create one by one updated backup for each and every session. I hope you enjoyed the full session what we have discussed today. So hopefully we can go to the discussion of the Zoom and get your problems to be discussed at the time when we are going with the Zoom discussion. So the window screenshots are showing how to take the backup, and please use that and take the backup into your company as well. Here I have mentioned a safe drive. but you don't, you may be not having the safe drive, any drive available in your computer. Please take the backup file and safeguard this final backup for the lecture number 2, that is APMA 2020 Company Limited and also COM 2020 Company. So both companies you need to have a 2 backup. COM students having their own backup and accounting students having their own backup. So the handouts will be little bit different from 2 departments, same information, but the company names are changed and the subject code and the name is changed, and the both parties will get your handout uploaded into the LMS. Please download. If you want to take the printout, take the printout and do this activity by typing it, or you can use as I did, open up and copy and paste this information, because it's a Word document, you can do so. We have not converted that into the PDF form whereby student can use it. I hope you enjoy the lecture number 2, and it's time for you now to look at this video and do the perfect activity and create your own companies. Accounting students need to finish with creating their APMA 2020 Private Limited Company, and also the BCom student need to create their BCom 2020 Private Limited by next week. Thank you. All the best for all of you.